Well, we're about halfway through day 5 of this sourdough starter, this new sourdough starter. And at the moment, it's still a bit, it still seems dormant. Visually, nothing much is happening. So I'm not going to bore you with this one today. It'll just be set aside. It still smells good, so I'm happy that everything's fine in there. Now, today I'm going to show you my little trick that I mentioned to make sure that you don't get mold forming on the side of your container. This is my mature starter, the one that I started back in September and that is still going strong. As you can see, there's a lot of activity there and it's ready to be used. I have enough now to make another bread today. So this is my very simple little tip that ensures that you never need to worry about what builds up on the side of your container. And the solution is as simple as this. This is a new container. Before I even start baking with this starter, I'm going to make sure that I set some aside, because the last thing you want to do is use your lovely starter, bake a lovely bread, stick it in the oven, take it out, be all proud about the lovely sourdough bread that you've just produced, and then to realize, oh, I've used all my starter, and now I have to start from scratch again and create a brand new starter from scratch. That is not what you want. So, the first thing you do before you even start thinking about baking is making sure you have starter for the next time. So you just take a spoon, a teaspoon, nice little dollop of it. So there you go. A good dollop of it. Stick it into your box, into your container, and then just mix this up with fresh flour, a good, you know, maybe a dessert spoonful of it, and enough water to make a paste that's about, you know, that sort of thickness. And then you set that aside, and that's your starting point for the next bake 2, 3, 4 days into the future. There you go. That's my trick. That's all there is to it. Because this is a fresh, new, clean container, mold doesn't even have a chance to build up. Once it gets to a certain level, you know, this fills up fairly quickly if you start feeding it, you will have cleaned this bowl, it will be nice and clean, you transfer it from here into there, you keep feeding it until it's baking time again, and then you repeat the process. That's all there is to it. That way your containers will always stay clean. That way mold will never get the chance to establish itself. Problem solved.